Hey, how are you? Thanks so much for joining me. This is Dovid Winiarz. Some people call me the Facebooker Rebbe. Some people call me Dovid. I'm not going to tell you the other things that some people call me, but it's good to be here. It's been quite an interesting day today. This morning I had to go for a procedure at the doctor, and I went into one of these places on Bay Parkway in Brooklyn. It's like a factory over there. There's, you know, cubicles lined up with curtains, one after the other, after the other, after the other, and they take you. And of course, you got to put on those ridiculous things that, you know, leave very little to the imagination. I always said that's why they call them, you know, the place in the hospital, they call it the ICU, because, you know, you put those things on and that's it. So fortunately, I was able to get another blanket to cover up with, some degree of modesty. And as I was laying there waiting for the doctor to come in, I was thinking and listening to the conversations going on all around me. And, you know, you could hear the doctor a few curtains down telling the person, well, it looks like it's benign and everything should be okay, but you know what? Take these things for 2 weeks and come back to me in 2 weeks and hopefully everything will be okay and have a nice day and thanks so much for coming. And I'm like, you know, wow. What that fellow must be thinking now when he leaves the doctor's office for the next 2 weeks, what's he going to be going through? Every day he's going to wake up wondering if that thing that the doctor found was benign or not. By the way, just as an aside, thank God I came out of there and the doctor said that obviously there's something wrong with his equipment because he said, oh, you're normal. I said, okay, well, now I know that your equipment's broken. But the reality is that thank God he said everything is okay. God willing, he says I'm as healthy as I should be for this age and it should continue till 120. But that being said, you know, this person a couple curtains down from me doesn't know if he's healthy or not. And he doesn't know what's going to be for the next 2 weeks. And my heart went out to him because, or her, I don't even know who it was, because this person now every day is going to be wondering and wondering and wondering what will be the results of their tests in 2 weeks. It's a frightening thing. And I was hoping that this person had faith and belief in God, and belief in Hashem, that Hashem exists and that Hashem is involved in our day-to-day lives. Because if this person does believe in Hashem, then that's who they could turn to talk to pray to hope to, for a good report in 2 weeks. You know, the Chovos HaLevavos says, the duties of the heart, says that a person is allowed to rely on whomever they choose. And that's a very important lesson. If a person relies on the government, for example, when things go wrong, they say, well, what's Obama doing? Or what's Bush doing? Or whatever it is. And they feel let down by humanity, by humans. And they're upset when the humans in Washington or wherever they're from don't answer their prayers and don't answer their screams for help. And if they rely on money, they could lose their job. They could lose all their money. They could lose everything. I mean, if Enron taught us anything, it's not to rely on job security. There's no such thing as job security. If you deserve your job, you'll have your job. If there's a reason for you to lose your job, you'll lose your job. And I don't wish that on anybody. But if somebody does lose their job, then it's a test. It's a test not just for you, of course, but it's a test for everyone around you to see how they'll react to the fact that you lost your job. In last week's Torah portion, it talked about how Yitzchak trembled, how Isaac trembled when he realized the mistake that he made by giving Esav the bracha, the blessing, instead of Yaakov, Jacob. And the verse tells us that he trembled because he realized that a mistake was almost made through him. And at the end of the verse, the verse reads, that Yitzchak said, and the blessing shall remain, something along those lines. Because what he did is he accepted the fact that Hashem was, an accident had to happen through him, a mistake had to happen through him, but since it happened, it was meant to be, and there was nothing he needed to do to correct that mistake. So it's an important lesson for all of us. When a mistake happens through us, let's not feel bad necessarily that it happened, because it was meant to be. But let's feel bad that it had to happen through us, and let's try to correct the mistake if we can, of course. But if we can't, let's not beat ourselves up forever. Because if a mistake happens that we can't correct, that's exactly what was meant to happen. It was meant to happen, and it was meant to happen through us. Let's try to improve ourselves for the future that we don't have to have mistakes happen through us. But that being said, I wanted to share with you, thank God, that everything's okay, doctor-wise. And I want to bless you, and I'll ask you to bless me, that not only should we always be healthy, but we should know we're healthy and not have to worry about tests running to and fro. And we should have everything wonderful. We're in the month of Kislev now, the month of the rededication of the temple after the Hanukkah miracle. And it's proof pudding that miracles do happen. Let's hope it's a season of miracles, recognizable ones, and have a great day. Talk to you later.